formation of a company. A company is governed by the Companies Act 2013. As per this act, it is mandatory for every company to get itself registered with the Registrar of Companies.
This process of registration requires the company to follow certain legal provisions which is specified under the Act. This process of registration is called as the stages in the formation of a company. There are three stages. The stage one is the promotion stage, stage two, registration and incorporation, stage three, capital subscription stage. The promotion stage starts right from the time a group of people come together with the idea of starting a company. They are called as the promoters. These promoters, having a business plan in hand, has to first do a feasibility study. They have to see whether the business plan in hand is financially, technically, and economically feasible. Whether they can raise enough funds to start the business, they have enough technical support to conduct the business, whether they can implement and execute the business successfully and achieve the overall objectives of the business. Having done with the feasibility study, they have to proceed with the people to manage the affairs of the company. That is, they have to find directors and choose a name for the company. While choosing the name of a company, they have to see to that the name of the company is not similar to the name of any other company which is already registered under the Companies Act. Then they have to get ready with the documents of the company, that is the Memorandum of Association and Articles of Association. Memorandum of Association is the external document which talks about the scope within which the company can operate with the outside world. And Articles of Association talks about the rules and regulations of the company. So Memorandum is an external document and Articles is an internal document. Then a company can raise capital by issuing shares to the public. For this purpose, they have to get ready with the prospectus. The prospectus is a document which invites the public to subscribe to the shares of the company. Then the promoters and directors should make all necessary arrangements. They should make all necessary arrangements for starting the business soon after getting the certificate of incorporation. So they should do enter into all preliminary contracts, which is the base work for starting the business. The next stage in the formation of a company is the registration and incorporation stage. At this time, their promoters has to decide about the type of the company, whether they are going to start a public company or a private company or a one-person company. After deciding that, they have to decide on the liability of the members. The liability of the members talks about the extent to which the members are liable to the debts of the company. If it is an unlimited liability, then the members' personal assets will also be liable to the company's debts at the time of winding up. If it is going to be a limited liability, then the members' personal assets will not be liable and the liability will be either limited by the number of shares or the value of shares held by the members or the value of guarantee given by the members. Then they have to apply to the Registrar of Companies with an application form along with the name of the company. This application form should be supported with the necessary supporting documents like the Memorandum of Association, Articles of Association. It should have an affidavit given by the subscribers. Affidavit is nothing but a statement or declaration given by the directors and promoters that there is no case against them in any court of law. Then a consent letter from directors given by the directors stating their acceptance to act as the directors of the company. The details of directors regarding their address, then their interest towards the company. All these details should be attached to the application form. Once the Registrar of Companies is satisfied with the details submitted, they will issue a certificate of incorporation. This certificate of incorporation will have an Corporate Identity Number, CIN. This is a unique number allotted to the company. This number is unique to the company and it will not be allotted to any other company under the Companies Act. This certificate of incorporation means that the company has come into existence legally. It is separate from its members and it can act in its own name. The next stage is the capital subscription stage. This capital subscription stage will not apply to a private company because a private company does not issue shares to the public. On the other hand, a public company issues shares to the public, so they have to undergo this capital subscription stage. So before they issue prospectus inviting the public to apply to the shares of the company, they have to get an approval from the SEBI. SEBI stands for Security Exchange Board of India. They are the regulator of the capital market. So before they issue prospectus, they have to get an approval from the SEBI and appoint brokers, underwriters and bankers for facilitating the allotment process. Once the minimum subscription is received, then a public company can commence its business. So regarding the commencement of business, a private company can commence business soon after getting a certificate of incorporation. On the other hand, a public company can commence business only after getting minimum subscription. So these are the stages in the formation of a company: promotion stage, registration and incorporation stage, capital subscription stage. Hope you understood the stages in the formation of the company. Thank you for watching the video.